All right. Well, we're about 10 seconds from liftoff. Let's listen in.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Engines full power. And liftoff, Falcon 9. Go Axiom.
It's 1 Alpha.
Copy, 1 Alpha.
Together, we expand what is possible in low Earth orbit. Ad Astra and Godspeed AX2.
Plus 36 seconds into flight. A great view of Falcon 9 heading to space.
Power telemetry is nominal.
Power telemetry nominal. We're into the throttle bucket. Is the first stage is throttle down power on the Merlin engines in preparation for max Q.
Falcon 9 is supersonic.
Faster than the speed of sound as we're getting great views from the first stage camera looking back at Kennedy Space Center Complex 39A.
Stage 1 throttle up.
Max Q.
We're out of the throttle bucket.
Stage 1 Bravo.
Copy, 1 Bravo.
We're at full power and that call out 1 Bravo, that's another one of those abort modes. As we get higher and faster, the logic for Dragon should a contingency occur changes from stage to stage.
Attack chill is underway.
Chill announcement says we're getting the turbo pump on the second stage engine cooled down in preparation for its light up coming up in just another minute from now. Again, great views looking back, and you can see the contrail as we left 39A and the shadow of the contrail against the cloud deck around Florida. Now we're coming up, three big sequences and a view live of the crew inside Dragon. They're getting ready. We're going to get three events here. Main engine cutoff, stage separation, and then we're going to light the second stage engine. We've heard the throttle down in preparation for stage separation.
Eco.
2 Alpha.
Stage separation confirmed.
Copy, 2 Alpha.
And back ignition.
Stage 1, boost back startup.
All right, stage separation. We've lit the second stage engine. The first stage is into the boost back burn, working its way back towards Cape Canaveral. Views on the left side, that's the first stage. Engines running as we come back to the launch site or the landing site. Second stage engine nozzle is visible on the right side as we're powering the Axiom 2 crew into low Earth orbit on the way to the International Space Station. Waiting for call out that the boost back burn is complete.
Stage 1, boost back shutdown.
Right on time. First stage completed the first of three burns heading back to the landing site. Second stage continuing on power and on trajectory.
Acquisition signal, Bermuda.
As we head northeast, the Bermuda ground station.
Dragon, SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
Bermuda is listening in to the vehicle now.
Nominal trajectory.
And the crew hears the call out of a nominal trajectory. So 4 minutes into flight, everything continuing to go well, first stage heading back, and there's the crew on the second stage getting the ride into orbit to the space station. Thank you. Coming up, we're waiting for the next trajectory call out from the guidance officer.
Dragon, SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
Ah, love to hear those words. A nominal trajectory for Dragon.
Copy. Nominal trajectory.
And maybe even a little bit of excitement in the crew's voice. Commander Peggy Whitson calling back down, hearing that call out from GNC of a nominal trajectory. Left side of the screen, you can see the first stage. It's now beginning to orient itself so that the engines are pointed down towards the land as we will be descending towards landing zone one in Cape Canaveral. The four titanium grid fins have all deployed. They'll help guide They'll guide the first stage through the once we get into the atmosphere following the entry burn, which will be coming up here in another couple of minutes. On the right-hand side, the second stage with the Dragon capsule on top, heading up the eastern seaboard of the U.S. We've just heard the call out of Boston. That's the New Hampshire tracking station has picked up the signal.
Dragon, SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
GNC continuing to make those call-outs that we want to hear. Everything continuing to look good. And the crew echoing them right back down. Good comms with the crew. We've been able to bring some live video shots from inside the capsule as they're headed to space. And there's another view of the crew.
Stage one, entry burn, startup.
And there we heard that the startup burn for that stage one booster, you can see it there on the left-hand side of your screen, has now begun.
Stage one, entry burn, shutdown.
And conclusion of that entry burn, that burn helps to slow the vehicle down as it re-enters the Earth's atmosphere. The first stage sees high drag, which scrubs roughly 70% of the velocity by the time
Dragon,
that landing.
Dragon, SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
Love to hear that call out. Everything
nominal trajectory.
Beautiful view of planet Earth coming to us from the second stage views on the right-hand side. Left-hand side, our first view of the Space Coast once again. This booster is attempting a landing at LZ-1.
Stage one, transonic.
That booster is now traveling near the speed of sound. Live view coming to you from one of our tracking cameras. We can see the grid fins actuating to help steer the booster down.
Stage one landing burn.
Stage two FTS has saved.
Standing by to...
Stage one landing leg deploy.
There you
stage
can
one landing confirmed.
You can see that first stage has landed back at LZ-1. This is the first time that we have performed a land landing on a crew mission. Coming up next will be second engine cutoff, or SECO, and that's where after that engine cuts off, the second stage will coast for a few minutes until Dragon is commanded to separate.
Stage two is in terminal guidance.
We're expecting SECO to occur in about 20 seconds.
Shannon.
Copy, Shannon.
Commander Peggy Whitson continuing to call out the abort modes.
SECO.
All right, on time shutdown of that second engine. Also confirming that the launch escape system is now disarmed.
Dragon, SpaceX, nominal orbit insertion.
All right, and there's that call out. We can confirm good orbital insertion.
Copy, nominal insertion.
Dragon, SpaceX.
All right, welcome back. You've been watching this very successful liftoff there at the Kennedy Space Center, and I want to go to you, Captain Kelly, to talk about this because, I mean, I have to apologize a little. I think we kind of undersold what we were about to watch. And that's all my fault. That's nobody else's fault. But, I mean, just what we witnessed there over the last 10 minutes or so was just extraordinary in that, Captain Kelly, we saw a landing of that booster stage one rocket. That was extraordinary. And then what we're seeing, I guess, happening right now is marvelous to watch as well, and that this is really a space travel, in many ways, a space travel mission that we're watching on the right side of the screen right now. Your thoughts, if you can help us unpack this, because I'm sure I've already screwed up the terminology in all of this, but you can tell I'm geeking out here. This is fun to watch.
Yeah, you know, Jim, when the space shuttle used to fly, that I had the privilege of flying twice on, it was always a lot of drama to get it safely into space, because it was such a complicated aerospace vehicle. There's so much that could go wrong. But with SpaceX, you know, they make it look easy. This was just like a no-brainer of launching four people into space, and to see one of my former classmates there, and three people I've never met before, but three rookies. Anytime you're flying new people in space, it's great. And to see them get there safely, very happy day.